Having to plan and direct is tiring. Can we say that? Can we say that? Hi, I'm Hazel.
Hi, I'm Azura.
And I'm Germaine.
And welcome back to this episode of Clarity's Hush Podcast. Yeah, today really a bit sad.
Really very sad.
Yeah. Germaine can't join us in the studio today because she is facing some issue, health issues. But not to worry, she's recovering.
She's okay. Resting well. Mm-hmm. It just feels very incomplete.
Yeah.
Like even earlier when we went for lunch, the place that we often go to, the people were just like, where's the third one?
They remember us by like the first, second and the third one,
yes,
you know.
Yes, correct.
Oh yeah, goodness gracious me. I remember there was one episode that you couldn't join us for the recording as well. And you know, it just feels different. I think the Hush Podcast just isn't complete without any of you girls.
Exactly.
In this episode, right, we're going to discuss something that I think I'm guilty of.
Ayo!
Right, and also you mentioned in episode 2, remember, when we talked about toxic masculinity, you brought up this point about how you hate it when your partner expects you to plan everything.
Oh, I got a shock there when I saw this, right? And I was like, huh? Inspired by me?
But do you still hate it when everyone expects you to plan everything?
Oh, actually, right, I just mentioned this over the past weekend.
Okay.
So, because I like to do like weekend brunches.
Right.
And then just so happened that Sunday, so he had something on in the morning first, so he went without me.
Okay.
And then after which, I texted him and I said, so where are we going? Which means like, give me a place, right?
Right.
Guess what he said?
Up to you.
No.
You decide.
No. He said, brunch. I said, yeah, no shit, Sherlock.
Today, we're going to discuss something called the mental load.
Okay.
Alright, so we weren't sure at the time if it was a gender thing, like you mentioned, having your partner plan all your things for you.
Right.
But we spoke about how women seem to be the gender that are always expected to plan for things because we are known to be meticulous or the better planner.
Right.
Which in all honesty, I don't deny lah.
Correct, it's true. But they'll just pass it off as,
right,
you're better at it, you do lah.
Yeah, but this is not an episode full of complaints. Definitely not at all. We're just opening this up for discussion, okay?
Correct.
If you have any thoughts, you know, you can just feel free to slide in our DMs as well.
That's right.
But apparently and unfortunately, I think you're right, it is a gender issue.
Okay.
Women, especially mothers in a two-parent heterosexual family,
okay,
just somehow are expected to run things as if they're project managers.
Okay, so right, just now when you mentioned delegating the work,
right,
I think some people have an issue with that.
Okay.
They consider that the root of the mental load issue.
I agree.
Okay,
I agree.
There was a very famous comic, right?
Okay.
That went viral some time ago.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, it starts off with this person visiting her friend's house.
Okay.
And so the said woman here is running around the house.
Okay.
She's trying to prepare dinner. She's trying to host a guest.
Okay.
And she's trying to feed her kids at the same time.
Mm.
The husband's just sitting there,
talking to the guest lah, basically.
Aww.
Entertaining the guest, doing his part as a host.
And
the pot is overflowing.
The
baby is crying. Time is running out.
That's right. And what does the guy say? Why you never ask me for help?
Goodness.
Then it feels like, must ask me.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of it, right, is like, must say me. You know, like, why do you need me to remind you? Or why do you need me to say? Or why do you need me to ask? Is it not obvious that I was running around? Okay, because this mental load thing,
right,
it encompasses so many things, right?
Mm-hmm.
So do you think it's like a never-ending thing? So first, you have to keep asking him to do it.
Yeah.
So asking or reminding is also a mental load because it's
you must remember to, I must ask my other half to do this.
And then when they do it already,
okay,
if you damn pick check then how leh?
That one you also must manage your own emotions. It's tough.
Okay. So I think I've experienced this, right, in let's say the kitchen.
Okay.
So I'm cooking something, for example. So I can cook, but I hate washing.
Okay.
So everyone will always wash up.
Mm-hmm.
That's the rule.
Okay.
I'm not washing.
Mm.
So but sometimes he wants to help me cook.
Uh-huh.
Or he will ask if I need help.
Uh-huh.
And then I say, yeah, can you help me, like, for example, peel the potatoes and chop it up.
Okay.
Okay. And it's something that I know I can do in like 2 minutes.
Okay.
But maybe 10 minutes has passed and I turn and he's still like, Mama la. Slowly. And then you then like,
right.
Hey, can you do it this way? Or like, why is it taking you so long? But I think I have to take a minute to like, okay.
Chill, calm down, right?
I cannot ask this person to do it the way I want to. Or it's like, okay, good enough that he's already wanting
he
to
offered
help.
To help you out.
Correct, correct. So just bite your tongue.
Yeah.
Hold it together and thank you, thank you. Thank you.
So I know in this episode we've been talking a lot about housework, but actually there's more to mental load than just housework. Once again, what is mental load? It is not just about the physical tasks, but rather the overseeing of all these tasks. It's being the one in charge of having the never-ending list of to-do items constantly running about in your head, remembering what needs to get done, by when, and delegating all the tasks to respective family members, your children, your husband, yeah, you know, and actually making sure they get done.
Correct. So you're really like the project manager.
Yeah.
You really run this role.
Exactly.
And you know, just now we spoke about like doing them, right? But far beyond just doing them, you are the person who has to remember.
Yeah, exactly.
Who has to keep track, you know? And you know, like, project manager is like a whole job of its own, right?
Yeah, our producer put a very interesting note here. Having to plan and direct is tiring. Can we say that? Can we say that? If you want your partner to plan and direct or micromanage you, then make sure you pay her for a role as household or relationship manager. And the salary, not bad one.
Come, tell me.
Okay. As a gauge, a project manager is paid an average of $76,188 every year.
Oh, no.
Ayoy! Finance manager, $80,132 every year.
Okay.
Business manager. Mm. Oh, I love this. $131,294 every year.
Can you imagine how much money we could be making?
Exactly! Huh? If we put this expertise somewhere else, right?
Correct.
We could be making the ka-ching ka-ching.
Correct. But I have to use this space.
Right.
For you. Also, with this expectation to run certain things, for example. Okay, I'll give you an example. I'm the messier one, right?
Okay.
Aaron's a neater one.
Okay.
So, I feel like he does more chores than I do.
Okay.
Like, he will literally say like, okay, I'm going to vacuum.
Aww.
And then I feel very bad. But then I think about it and I'm like, do I have to feel bad? Should I feel bad? Why is it that when he says that he's going to do it, that I feel that I'm not doing my job? How come I feel that way? Like, he also live here. You know what I mean? Then I question like, should I feel bad? Am I supposed to do it instead? Why do we have this perception like, oh, if he's volunteering to do it or if he's saying to do it, means like I didn't do my job.
Right.